Exactly. It's
a mutual, if you at home cussing your
thing.
Kids out, what the fuck
do
you think
like,
they doing at school?
Look, I say yes, sir, and no, sir, to my son. I was in Lowe's one day, and this white lady said, "Did you just say yes, sir?" She said, "Did you say yes, sir, to him?" I said, "Yeah." She said, "Why? That's a child." I said, "Because I respect him." And she was like, "Oh, I never heard of that before." I said,
"Listen, you're blowing my mind. I do it jokingly, but I don't mean it."
See, I mean it because I guess I'm raising, and this is no disrespect to nobody how they raise their children, because
I ain't even disrespecting how you do it. I'm just saying, yeah. I've never heard that.
Yeah, but because it's just a level of respect. I teach him how to be respectful to everybody. You know what I mean? Like I learned it because my father was in the military, so I had to say yes, sir, and no, sir. But then as I went on with life, and I got into corporate America, like even in corporate America, sometimes I say yes, sir, to my CIO, and he like, "Oh, you ain't got to say that." And I said, "No, that's a level of respect." But what I've taught them, now they say it back to me. You know what I mean? Like, yes, sir, no, sir. It's just the level of respect that you got to have for, you know, like across the board, like respect will take you so many different places, man. And if a child does not have that at 4 years old, if he's a fucking little devil like that and the daddy can't control him.
I done had certain homeboys that came in front of me and cussed in front of my children. I don't particularly like that. And I had to say, don't use that language around my little baby girl or my little son. You know, don't use that language, right? They see how I handle them, but I'm not saying yes, sir, no, sir, to him or my children, but they see that I demand my respect, but I give it, right? So in that, it's different ways to convey the message.
Yeah,
that's why I'm not shunning how you raise your kids, because if that works for you, that's it will work for your children. Listen to me, audience and guest. I respect each and every one of y'all household. If it makes them a better human being, guess who's saluting that? Jermaine. Right.
Here's something that I learned later. A lot of us, we grew up, well, I know I grew up in a fussing household. Fussing all day long, nagging, da-da-da-da-da.
Baby, I'm from the country.
Listen. Kids have to learn emotions. At this day,
learn to manage emotions.
That's true. At this day and age, I still get emotional and sometimes can't control my emotions. You've had a kid lose a toy and they get to crying. That's a loss. They're going through their emotions. They don't know how to control their emotions. And then what as a parent? It's okay, stop crying. You all right, get another toy. You got other toys in there, da, da, da. But that's a loss. And it hurts because, oh my God, I've had this toy for all this time and it's gone. This is something that I want. This is what I learned this maybe like 2 or 3 years ago. Because my girls are real emotional. Oh, child, drama queens. And Ayana is my oldest and she's the biggest drama queen ever. And she's the most loving kid that you'll ever meet. But it's not a problem. Hard for her to control her emotions. So sometimes she's like, something's wrong. What? I don't know. Well, what do you mean? I just feel like I want to cry. Do you need me to give you a hug? Yes, mama can. I swear to you, every single day we hug. We out. Cool. We look at that.
But you know what that speaks to, right? Her love language being developed. That's it. If but you don't know that a love language of a child, some people really, real deal, have love languages you won't understand because it's not yours.
You're so
it's
right.
Because it's not yours.
So if you don't understand the love languages, then you won't understand your kid, another adult, or a stranger.
And I can't lie, I don't, but I try.
You know what we do? Let me tell you the biggest stigmatism out here in the world. The oldest profession in the world is hoeing, right or wrong.
It's okay.
sex
work. Oh, yeah, you're right.
Let's be honest, right? It's misguided.
Mm-hmm.
It's misguided for a lot of reasons I can speak on, but we're not going to go down that rabbit hole. But here's my thing. Some of them, majority of them that I've talked to, doing my thing, interviewing people, talking to people, most of them, 98% of them, it wasn't because of sexual abuse. It wasn't because somebody touched them or somebody showed them that. Yeah, they got those problems in their past, but people that have made successful situations out of it have come from it and ain't did nothing like sexual work, right? But here's the thing. These people, love languages were gifts, physical touch. And because it was mismanaged, it turned into sexual work. Right?
Yep.
But that conversation is hard to have with somebody that doesn't do it.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
You quick to judge. Mm-hmm. You like, why are you selling yourself? You so beautiful. You could be doing so many other things.
I said that to a stripper at the strip club.
And that's what we're supposed to do when we encounter everybody on a day-to-day basis. We're supposed to speak life into them.
And remember that it takes other people different levels of time.
When you see it, that's when it really reflects.
Well, like, oh my God. Only still cool to this day for one reason. The guy that I was with when she lap danced, did a thing on me, you know, I introduced him and I was like, my partner, he's shy. He don't do the strip club thing I do. You know what I'm saying? You know, and then I continue to fertilize their relationship by passing messages, right? But the thing I understood about him is he wasn't going to never say, I really like her because of the environment.
Mm-hmm.
She wasn't going to never say she really liked him because we viewed her in a certain way. It was her body for our cash. So she was thinking lower of herself at the time. And she didn't even want to be there. It just paid the bills. But what I want to say at the end of it, let y'all talk. I believe that love languages 100% have a lot to do with how we mistreat each other. We don't understand. We go into the situation, assert ourselves, make what our demands are important rather than how do I treat you? We don't look at the blueprint of how you want to be treated most times. We just say, oh, no, I ain't going to accept that. We got a long list of what we won't accept.
See, Belinda, thing that you got,
are you really saying you a lie?
No, listen, here's one thing that you got to realize is if I already feel comfortable in who I am and, you know, what I'm doing and what I got going on. Now, if it's something, okay, I go out on Thursdays. Okay, look, I can compromise you going out once a month on Thursdays. Okay, that's different. But if it's something like you got to compromise going to the gym 7 days a week, bitch, what? You know what I'm saying? Like, it depends on what it is. Because don't come at me sideways about some compromise. It depends on what
it's got to be reasonable. It's got to be a reasonable compromise.
I got you. But I can do that.
There are exceptions. Yes. Go ahead, Mr. Rod. I won't cut you off.
No, I was just saying it's got to be reasonable compromises. You know what I mean? Like,
I'm not speaking in terms of the people that are mentally unstable, that don't know how to manage their emotions, that absolutely carry the baggage of their trauma. And they haven't figured out that it's even trauma yet. They think operating in chaos is normal. I'm not speaking. I've learned more from the women that cheated on me than the women that treated me right.
Mm.
You hear me? I didn't know who I was until I got cheated on. Because I was doing all the cheating.
Well, you're supposed to learn.
I actually wasn't doing all the cheating. I was single. I was helping them cheat. You know what I'm saying? They was cheating.
But if
they was committed. Huh?
If you were single, how were they cheating?
How were they cheating?
If you were single.
They was married.
Then how were they cheating on you?
They had boyfriends.
Husband. Oh. Okay, okay.
They had boyfriends.
Got you.
So naturally, okay. Indirectly, like I was cheating.
Okay.
I was wrong. You know what I'm saying? So I learned more about when I decided that I'm officially in love and off the market from the women that decided to do me like I had done so many others. I learned more about those situations than the women that came and just wanted to do right by me.
And that's
but I'm just saying, I'm so glad they cheated on me, because what I dished out,
yeah,
I didn't know I couldn't handle.
But yeah,
you know, each
thing. Absolutely.
So, you know how men, y'all men are, and I'm not gonna say all, but let's be real, men.
We're speaking in generalities. This is not absolute.
Stop. Hold on. Men cannot take the same hurt they put on a woman.
There's a reason.
That's true though, because I agree with that 100%. Because
let her finish, and then
you can be with a man and they cheated several times, and then you don't even cheat. You just so called slick talk to a nigga. That nigga gonna motherfucker want to kill the world.
Ain't it?
But I didn't put up with this shit for all these times.
It's still cheating.
When that shit, nah. Man. It ain't love. Even. Let me tell you something.
Belinda.
You know what? Belinda, I wish I didn't know y'all. I wish everybody didn't know me Belinda, personally, because I could talk about some real life experiences.
No, but you can. Just don't say no names.
Me, I can't.
Don't say no names.
I got accused one time of a pastor, right? Ain't never in my life had no words to
a pastor. You fuck somebody.
He called and cussed the pastor out. Had no type of any on God. And I'm just like, where did you get this from?
Like, security
men, y'all are real territorial. And especially, yes, we are too. But I'm saying, especially when, okay, so we've been going to this church and you've been, what? No? What? It ain't even got to be nothing, but it could just be just the thought of it. I've always said this. Men are more emotional than women. Yeah. That part.
They are. They just come out of handling.
Just don't know how to show it or say it. And we got to blame a generational thing, because, you know, boys not supposed to cry. You supposed to be hard. That's
not what it is.
What is it?
The moment a man gives you emotion, it's thrown in our face. So we hold on.
I think it depends on the level of woman that you're dealing with.
Speaking in absolutes. I'm speaking in the majority. There's always an exception to the rule. The majority of guys cannot confide in you because it's a sign of weakness.
Raised wrong.
Because the moment you're done with me, you're gonna tell another nigga where I was weak at, because he don't ask.
Never.
So yeah, go ahead, baby.
No, that's just a few. You're the few.
We like that.
Belinda, you're
never
the
in
few.
My life that I done set up and talked about a nigga at his lowest with another nigga. That's
Belinda,
not.
Baby, you know what you got to understand right now?
That ain't how it goes.
You two are the few, but I've experienced it. When she was done with me, she told him all my vulnerabilities.
But see,
well, she not was just stupid. She should have been smart.
Several.
I would I'm never. I would. Because first of all, if we together, you was with.
And then I talked to my guys. They're telling me the same stories. It's not that it was just in the circle. Of
yeah,
women. I was the wrong.
For me,
it's in
listen,
women.
I but know, could.
No,
but could it?
My bad.
Go ahead, Rob.
So, but everything, when we look at everything that we discuss, everything is a mindset, everything is a level. So, the mindset of that woman, the level she was on, you get what I'm saying? So, if she's not if she not mature enough to for you to come to her. So let's use this as an example. Mickey or Belinda, I'm dating one of y'all. I'm just gonna throw it out there. Belinda, I'm dating you. And
I want to. No, I'm
playing. Yeah. So look at this. So say for instance, Belinda and I dating, right? I'm working and I'm dealing with some shit at work. And let's say I done got depressed or I done got anxiety. But I'm coming to her.
Please don't take my absence for not listening. I'm listening. I just got to grab something right
now. No, you cool, bro. So I'm confiding in her at the end of the day. Like, damn, man, these motherfuckers get on my nerves. They got me like, man, I can't breathe. Like, and I'm going to the doctor. And for her, as my woman, she should step up and have that conversation. Be like, baby, this is what we need to do, da-da-da-da-da. Say what?
The peace.
Yeah. So, and if we split 3 years later, and you go back and be like, man, this nigga, he was at work, he couldn't handle, he was having anxiety attacks, then guess what? To me, it's the reason that we ain't together, right? That's the way I look at it, because I don't...
So, the thing about it is, as at my age, I would never. When you go, we all go through life, and you know, life hits hard at times.
Right. So
when life hit me hard, I'm supposed to come tell you, and when life hits you hard, you're supposed to come tell me. Up talking about when you done got to your lowest and when you feeling like this or whatever else. But see, that's another thing though. We as Black people alone, we go through shit. We go through depression. We go through anxiety. We go through all of this shit, and we don't want to get help.
Yep.
Feel like we can work it out. No, sometimes you need actual professional help.
Absolutely.
And I'm not gonna lie, I did it myself, and it helped me out. Girl, you have really sets a different tone for your life to let you know to where okay. This ain't gonna come in and destroy my peace, and I'm not gonna let anything come in and disrupt my peace. But we grew up thinking that, oh no, nah, you crazy.
That's
you
weak. Somebody. That's you weak.
Somebody, you crazy. What's going on? You take some depression pill. Look, man, everybody don't know how to handle it, and you could say this and that worked for you, but it might not work for the next person. But as a woman with a man, ain't no way. I'm not going to talk about him. One of the things that we got to realize is a man's supposed to be a man at the end of the day. So I wouldn't want to belittle him to no other man. I don't give a fuck what we went through. I'm not going to talk about you and talk about you when you were at your lowest. If you cried on my motherfucking shoulder, you cried on my shoulder. You went through it, you went through it. Ain't nobody going to hear about that shit. I'm going to deal with it because now it's going to make me feel some type of way because it's certain things we can't help with and certain things we can't. So, yes.
He is human.
But at the same, it shows that we're human, you know? But at the same time, for Belinda to step up and be by my side when I'm going through something, it shows that we are a unit.
Yeah.
And we're going to another level with each other. So if we not together no more and she's still running and she pillow talking to the next nigga, guess what? It's the reason that we not together anyways. It's the reason that we end up.
You want to know something, though? And this is me from my point of view and from what I've seen. Majority of niggas start pillow talk. It be the nigga. I didn't have to cut many of niggas off when they... That's a turnoff for me. Don't talk about no other nigga to me. That's a turnoff. When you come trying to tell me about, oh, yeah, that nigga... What? What?
Can I tell you a secret, Miss Belinda? Go ahead, Miss Ross.
Swear to God, I had a nigga inbox me one time telling me all this shit about what he heard my ex was doing. And I was like, and you concerned about it for what?
And, but see, like,
okay.
I'm just but saying, see, nigga, but why are you worried about it?
There's an answer for that.
What's
but go ahead, Mr. Rod. I'll answer after you go ahead.
Niggas think that's gonna get them the pussy. That's what some think. See, I was raised, my cousins in Miami, like them niggas always used to tell me, nigga, you like when you get with a bitch, and I'm sorry, let me take that back. When you get with a female,
JJ,
you ain't worried about the next nigga. Fuck him. But that's just the way that we grew up here. And, you know, even though I lived in Tennessee, don't get me wrong, but I'm a real live Florida boy. You know what I mean? Watch the eyes.
Hold on. Stay focused. Make your point, bro.
But I let me tell you something. I don't give a fuck about no other nigga. Let me tell you something. I ain't laying on the pillow talking about, man, da-da-da-da-da. Man, fuck that nigga.
Come on.
I got a whole story to tell.
I'm stepping away two seconds. I'll be right back.
Up front.
We love you.
Listen, I got a whole story to tell. This is baby daddy back in the day. So I called myself getting mad at my son's father. Well, I wasn't pregnant then. We was just dating this before I got pregnant. Because he done went off and cheated with such. So one night I'm in the Dynamic Six and I see this dude. So I have a one night stand, right? We ain't talking about nothing. We just getting going. We doing it. Okay. Then we later decide to chit-chat and figure out who is who. Have a conversation. Want to know who is who. Tell me why that was my baby's father. First sergeant. So now this dude got to look at him every day knowing he done smashed me, his girl, even though he was out cheating. Yeah. It was dirty. So, of course, I went ahead and told the truth. I almost got my head put through the window and whatnot. You know what I'm saying? I had to deal with that. But so from now on, I was like, man, let me start talking first. Let me find out who this person knows. You know, yeah, man. It was an ugly situation, Shaylin. That was ugly. I ain't never been so scared in my life. You know, I like to fight, but I was scared to death that day. You know, that's why I'm honest. And y'all know right now, we all grew up together.
Yeah.
Clarksville is small. Every last
oh one. Lord,
look at Carl.
Oh, well, why we all large? We're
gonna bump heads.
I love y'all.